Jackson, Mississippi. It's known as the Crossroads of the South, or the City with Soul. It's a place that's been recognized for its Southern hospitality from its people and its Southern comfort from its restaurants. Being Mississippi's largest city, you can expect the hustle and bustle found in metropolitan areas. But through it all, Jackson is able to keep its small-town feel alive. And it's that small-town atmosphere with a sprinkling of big-city living that permeates through the rest of the state. Country living is still in full force here, and its place in helping Mississippi's ag industry can't be understated. Fortunately, there's the Mississippi Farm Bureau. Land, scholarships, insurance, you name it. The Mississippi Farm Bureau is run by farmers with the goal of making farm life a little bit easier for its more than 192,000 member families.
Hey, Mike, how are you? Good to see you, man.
Good, Troy. How about you?
I met up with Bureau President Mike McCormick, who was on site at the Jackson Fairgrounds conducting some business. No horsing around here. I wanted to learn a little more about him and what Mississippi Farm Bureau is doing for farmers across the state.
When farmers have talked to you, what are some of the things that they really appreciate that Mississippi Farm Bureau has done?
We have so many wins. If you look at our legislature just a few years back, we worked on an eminent domain issue where nationally some of the states were taking our private property and using it for private use. Mississippi Farm Bureau got together with some legislators and said that was wrong, that we need to use eminent domain for what its intended purposes were. And we actually had to go to initiative on a ballot to get it, get that situation fixed. That was a big win for us, but we win things on a daily basis for our farmers, whether it's fighting a little small battle on an issue for a single farmer, or if it's something for the whole state or nation, we're working on those every day.
So obvious to anybody who lives here, Mississippi is such a great place to be a farmer. What makes it such a great place to be a farmer?
I think it's the diverse climate and soils that we have here in Mississippi. It allows our people to grow anything from catfish to sweet potatoes. In the Delta region, our ground there is just, we're blessed with some of the richest farmland on the planet. When you move around the state, the ground is more suitable for other things. In my part of the world, in southwest Mississippi, timber and cattle are our biggest crops that we produce. When you get over in the southeastern part of the state, vegetables, blueberry crops, and poultry is big.
Poultry's huge.
Poultry's huge. It's in our number one industry here in Mississippi. Agriculture is our number one industry. Poultry is at the top of that. So poultry has been a wonderful, wonderful thing. It allows people that wouldn't have a lot of acreage out there to be able to go back to their farms and make a living on the farm. We're very proud of our poultry industry.
Do we talk about catfish too?
Catfish, our catfish guys have struggled a little bit in the past, but we're coming back strong. We have some challenges out there. We have some importation of catfish that isn't really catfish. It's not safe to eat. We had to do a lot of work to get a lot of our inspection rules in. It's been under attack now for the last couple of years to stop that. And Mississippi Farm Bureau, along with catfish industry groups, have spent a lot of time in Washington protecting our catfish industry.
Yeah, and that's just one of the programs that Mississippi Farm Bureau is helping farmers with. What are some other programs you guys are doing?
We're really proud of all of what we do, but I think helping our young farmers and ranchers get started and giving them a platform to where they can be involved with an organization that gives them a voice as a whole instead of a single voice is most important to them. But we put a lot of time and effort in that program. I encourage the young kids in the state of Mississippi to reach out to their local county farm bureaus and get involved. They'll find that it's very educational, but also a time to meet people that are doing the same things that they're doing, hearing the challenges that they're having on their farms, and network between themselves with people that they'll know the rest of their lives.
One thing you seem really excited about is farm families. What's the deal with that?
A little before 2010, a group of us got together and decided we needed to do a whole lot better job of telling our story about agriculture here in the state of Mississippi. What we find is there's a lot of misconceptions about what farmers do, how we take care of our land, how we take care of our crops and our livestock. So we got together and decided we needed a group, an organization outside of Farm Bureau, and we established the Farm Families of Mississippi. And what we do is we do a lot of education and outreach through television ads, television commercials, billboards, and through social media to let everybody here in Mississippi know what our farmers are doing and Mississippi are doing for them on a daily basis.
The partnership between Mississippi Farm Bureau and Mississippi State Extension is also pretty unique.
We have a perfect partnership with Mississippi State. I'm very lucky to have this partnership that other state farm bureaus don't have. They come to Mississippi and they're envious of what we have, but we've always looked at it as working hand in hand on behalf of our farmers in the state. We go through so many different programs and with Extension. They develop so many different ideas for our farmers. They're the ones that are responsible for all of the cutting edge technology that we're seeing for our farmers that keeps us in business. But for Mississippi Farm Bureau, what we depend on them for is the information that they can give back to us. One thing that I'm very proud of that we work on with Mississippi State is a fact book that we develop with Extension every year. And these are something that we hand out to the legislators. We keep in our county offices for anybody that comes in and explains each county and each commodity that we have and how much of an impact that is for that county and state. Our whole state in the state of Mississippi. It's a wonderful little book, and it helps us tremendously tell our story as farmers.
So what's your story? Did you always want to be a farmer?
You know, I did. It was never a time in my life that that's not what I wanted to do. I was very fortunate to grow up on a pretty large row crop farm. My dad, other than just a few years serving in the military, in the Navy during World War II, never took a paycheck off our farm. Everything that he had, that he made right there. And, through the years, I was lucky enough to come back to Jefferson County, back to our home farm. My dad's passed away, and I have my cattle operation there and on adjoining farm that I bought. There's not a day in my life serving as a Farm Bureau president that I would consider myself anything other than a farmer. That's who I am, and that's what I love to do. And I just thank the Lord that he's given me this opportunity and hope that I'm able to do it the rest of my life.